Well, hello, friends. Bring your greetings on this beautiful day and praise God for the gift of this day, for our opportunity to be together in the Word. And today we're going to spend a little time with the minor prophet Malachi. We're going to be looking at the very end of the second chapter and leading into the third as we start looking at the prophecy surrounding Jesus Christ, but specifically here, the prophecy surrounding John the Baptist, who was sent before Christ as one who would prepare the way. So we talked a little bit yesterday about the nature of a prophet, that it's not a future teller or a foreign teller or a fortune teller, but rather the element of one who was proclaiming how God will act amidst his people. And some of it was, this is how God will act in terms of a response to bring forth blessing or to bring forth judgment, but then also other circumstances in which God is going to bring about God's will, period. And that's, again, one of the prophecies that we're digging into today. So in verse 17 of the second chapter of Malachi, if you're still having problems finding it, it's, you know, a little past the middle of your Bible. That's where you find all the minor prophets. And it's actually just before you get into the New Testament. So verse 17 says, "You have wearied the Lord with your words." How have you wearied him, you ask? By saying, "All who do evil are good in the eyes of the Lord, and he is pleased with them." Or, "Where is the God of justice?" And so we can see there's an aggravation here. There is an attitude amidst the people that people are doing evil, and they're saying, nope, everything we're doing is acceptable in the eyes of the Lord. And this is how the response shows up in chapter 3, verse 1. It says, "I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me. Then suddenly the Lord you are seeking will come to his temple. The messenger of the covenant, whom you desire, will come, says the Lord Almighty." So we talk about this, and there's a prophesied one who would lead, and the Lord is speaking through Malachi and saying, I will be coming to my temple, but there is one who I will be sending before me. All this is written before the birth of Jesus Christ, before the birth of John the Baptist, and here's how we talk about God's proclamation of what he is going to bring about. So God's people are living rebelliously. He says, I'm going to send one ahead of me before I enter in the world. What is that one to do? Well, as we read in the New Testament, he is preaching a baptism of repentance. He is bringing basically accountability to the Israelite people and saying, folks, you have been rebelling against God. You have been sinning against God, and you need to turn and repent of your sins that you might receive God's mercy and receive God's grace. And there's one who's going to follow me. And he is the embodiment of grace. He is the one. So this is the prophecy of Malachi talking about John the Baptist, who would be born to prepare the way for the Messiah. Friends, when I think about Christmas and I think about our calling in this day, we know that the Messiah was born. He was born into our lives. We know that he lived, that he taught the people. He revealed the kingdom of God, and he ultimately gave his life as a sacrifice in place of ours. We, like John the Baptist, are called to be the ones who go and proclaim to the whole world, who prepare the whole world for his return. So we're not preaching a message of the baptism of repentance as much as we are. We're saying there is a baptism into Jesus Christ, into knowing his grace, into knowing the abundant grace of God poured out, where we are regenerated, renewed, freed of our sin, and freed to live in relationship with God Almighty. Friends, the revelation will come one day, and it's not something to fear. It'll be a glorious day where Christ returns, but there are many, many, many who do not know him, and we, like John the Baptist, ought to be out in the world proclaiming the message, proclaiming the gift that God has given. That's the message of Christmas. It's the message of Easter, and it's the work of the Holy Spirit in and through you and me. Friends, it's been great being with you today, and I praise God for our time together. I pray you always know God loves you, and so do I.